Welcome to Durham AME Zion Church Visionary Outreach Broadcast. Your host is Reverend Leonard A. Edwards. Now, let us enter in service.
God, first and foremost, we just want to say thank you and bless your holy and righteous name, God. As we come to your throne, we ask that you will come into this worship experience, oh God. Let it not be for form or fashion, because we are not here, oh Father God, to impress, but God, we are here to have you impress your spirit upon us. Have your way with us, oh Father God, and surely at the end of it all, we will give your name glory and praise. In Jesus Christ, oh Lord, we pray. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Come on, put your hands together, give God some praise. We are so very grateful, amen, to be in God's house one more time. Amen. We are grateful to see each and every one of you. Amen. And we're going to have our communion experience on the day. But before we do that, let's receive a word from the Lord. But even before that, let's plow the field. Amen. Amen. With song. Let us now encourage Sister Gladys Roberts to come and to bless us with our opening selection. Come on. Sister Gladys Roberts.
Church.
Good morning.
I'm going way back this morning.
Amen, amen. Come on, Gladys.
Pray on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer. And how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Hallelujah.
Amen. Come on, put your hand in to give God praise.
Amen.
He said, pray just a little while longer. Amen. I was wondering whether or not she crept into my study and peeked over my shoulder and looked at the message, amen, that the Lord has been leading me to share with you on the day. Amen. Because surely sometimes we need to be able to put our trust in God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So I'm going to ask that you open up your scriptures on the day, your Bibles, your swords. Amen. But before you do that, come on, give God a praise. Okay, that's beautiful because I told you to do it. And now think about something this week that God delivered you from. Give God a praise. Don't waste no time. Amen. Just give God glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Whether that you be at home, whether that you be here inside the sanctuary. Amen. It's a good thing to give God glory and praise. Matthew, the 15th chapter. Matthew, the 15th chapter, starting at the 21st verse. Matthew 15, the gospel according to Matthew. Amen. I'm so glad to be in God's house again.
Amen.
I'm so glad to see God's people.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I believe in God.
Amen.
Amen. God is an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is a trustworthy God.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Amen. Matthew, the 15th chapter, starting at the 21st verse. When you have it, let me know by saying amen.
Amen.
Feel like preaching on the day. Amen. Feel like sharing God's word with you on the day.
Amen.
And then there's times I don't feel like it, but I'm going to do it anyhow.
Amen.
Amen. Because that's what you've been called to do.
My.
The word of the Lord be as follows. Then Jesus went thence and departed and crossed the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. But he answered her not a word, and his disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she crieth after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs. And she said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. Her daughter was made whole from that very hour. May the Lord add his richest blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. May he sanctify in your hearts with faith and thanksgiving. Come on, my father's children. And just be in agreement with the word of God and say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us now stand for our affirmation of faith by the use of our Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, our only Son, the Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. Third day he rose from the dead, he ascended in heaven, and sitteth on the right hand, Father Almighty, for them to come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, forgiveness of sins, remission of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. You may take your seats. I wonder, Gladys, can you and the rest of the churches help me with this? That you can't beat God's giving. Amen. Praise the Lord. You can stay in your seat.
Just as you are living, and the Lord is in heaven on high, I know the more you give, the more He gives to you. Just keep on giving, just keep on giving, because it's really true. I tell you that you can be God's giving, no matter how you try.
He sends
the sun.
Come on,
he sends the rain.
God, we just continue, oh Father God, in this worship experience. Amen.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Just saying thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
In a matter of fact, oh Father God, we just want to just be by your altar and just shout out thank you just for a minute. Amen, God. Before we ask you for anything, God, we just want to say thank you. We know, oh Father God, that you've been working in our lives.
We know, oh Father God, that you have showed up right on time. We know, oh Father God, that you have delivered us out of the hands of the enemy. We know, oh Father God, that when we were down, you was the one that brought us back up. We know, oh Father God, that you are the only one, the only wise and powerful God. We know that you control heaven and earth, oh God, and we give your name praise. We give your name honor, and we give your name glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. I ask, oh God, that you will touch us one more time, God. God, we need your medicine on today. There's all sorts of diseases in the medicine journals, oh Father God. Doctors go to school for over 10, 12 years, and yet, God, you are the number one doctor that we will ever have, that we will ever need. Prescribe unto us your Holy Ghost. Touch us with your finger one more time. We ask us healing from the top of our heads to the bottom of the soles of our feet. Hallelujah, God. And we make sure, God, that we give a name glory, praise, and honor. And yet, God, we ask your blessings, not just to stop with us, but bless our household, our loved ones, our relatives, our family members, no matter where they may be. Bless them even now in the name of Jesus. We know everybody don't know who you are, God. That everybody can see salvation. But we pray that all will be saved by your grace, by your mercy, by your sacrifice that you have made for us. While we're here, cover us with your blood. Make us white as snow. Thank you, God, for forgiving our sins and lies. Hallelujah, God. And then, God, we pray for our circumstances. Stuff that surrounds us. Stuff we walk in. Stuff, oh God, that we can't just walk away from. But we got to live in it. Walk in it. Survive in it. But have faith in it. Have trust in it. Have knowing that every season has a beginning. And every season has an end. So God, help us to hold on. Hold on. Hold on to the unchanging end. Thank you for being the same God yesterday. Thank you for being the same God today. Thank you for being the same God on tomorrow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Well, God, this is the week. Amen. This week is coming. This week, this Tuesday, squad. Declares the decision day. But I thank you that you have already decided. You have already passed your judgment. Hallelujah, Lord. We cry out and we lift up, oh Father God, righteousness in this election. Let right be right. Rebuke lies. Rebuke deception. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. And through it all, no matter who walks into the house, we understand who has built that house. We understand the sacrifices, the lives that was caused to build that house that called White House. And yet, you are God. Hallelujah. You don't need the title of president. You are Alpha and Omega. You are the beginning and the end. So thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God. Mercy. Mercy. Mercy! Have mercy on us! Oh, Son of David. have mercy on us. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Woo. Thank you, God. Oh, God, thank you. Woo.
Thank you.
Oh. In Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, our Lord, our Lord. Our Lord. Our Redeemer. Our Savior. The Son of God. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. You may go back to your seat. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. What a mighty God we serve. Come on. What a mighty God
we serve.
What a mighty. Come on, what a mighty.
What a mighty God we serve.
God praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. 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 I am just always at awe at the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Even though sometimes, you know, we're not sure what's going to happen in that next moment. Amen. God is always present. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. You know, I am reminded. Amen. When we got to do roll call or attendance, you know what I'm talking about. Amen. Amen. Somebody say your name, and we wait to hear the hear part. Amen. You don't hear a name. Amen. You don't. Your name is called out. Amen. You don't answer. You're absent. But that's not the same with God.
Amen.
Amen. You could call on the name of the Lord. Lord is never absent.
Amen.
I wish somebody heard me on that. Amen, amen, amen. God, amen. God has never, ever, ever, ever got a late or a tardiness showing up. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is always in attendance.
Yes,
amen, amen, amen. Thank you so much, young man. Amen, for blessing us on the day. Amen. We appreciate your spirit. I love it. Amen. Came, sat down, observed what was going on. I watch everything. Amen.
Amen.
Came, observed what was going on. Amen. Got up, sashayed, you know, amen, you know, to the drum set. And I'm like, okay, what are you going to do now? He reached into his jacket. Amen. Pulled out his drum. Yeah, I watched him. Pulled out your drum set. Straightened some stuff out.
Amen. But amen. But thank you so much. Amen. Amen. He came prepared to serve. He came prepared to serve. Amen. He wasn't sure whether or not he was going to be needed. But he walked out the house and made sure he stuck it right in his jacket. Amen. Amen. So give God praise. Amen. For following his example. Amen. Be prepared to serve. Because you never know when God will call upon you. Amen. And God don't call with a loud voice. Amen. He would just say, yeah, it's your time. Go on there. Amen. 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 Well, Sister Gladys, I'm so glad you've been called to serve because, amen, I'm calling your name now again. Amen. First Sunday, amen. We're just grateful for you. Amen. Once again, encourage her. Put your hands together. Choose for me to sing this morning. So let you get this time, and then after that, I will bring you what thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm running for my life. 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 If anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Just tell them I'm saved and sanctified. Holy Ghost filled and fire and fire. I got Jesus on my mind. I'm running for my life. 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 If anybody asks you, what's the matter with me?
Amen, amen, amen. I'm running for my life. Amen, amen. Thank you, Sister Roberts, for ministering to us on the day. Amen, amen, amen. This is a time that we share the word of God with you. Amen. And I'd like you to reopen your Bibles. Amen. To the scriptures that was read for your hearing. Amen. Coming from the gospel according to Matthew. The gospel according to Matthew, amen, 15th chapter, we read for your hearing, the 21st through the 28th verses, amen. Our key verse, our text that we will use on today is coming from the 27th and 28th verse. The 27th and the 28th verse. Let me know when you are there by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The word of the Lord, amen, says this. And she said, "Truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." My goodness. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, "O woman, great is thy faith.
Yes.
Be it unto thee even as thou wilt." And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. And her daughter was made whole that very hour. I want to preach around the subject, elevated by crumbs. Did somebody hear me?
Amen.
Elevated by crumbs. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, here I am once and again standing before your people. Who am I to say a word on your behalf? Except, O Lord, that you have called me to this task. So I ask, O Father God, use me like you never used me before. Hide this wretched man that I am behind the cross, that men and women won't see or hear me, but that they will see and hear you. Open this mouth boldly to make known the mysteries of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in bonds, and therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. In Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And amen. Elevated by cross. My Father's children, imagine you being this mother in this circumstance. Imagine a parent having to deal with an illness, a sickness. The Bible says it was a possession, demonic possession of her daughter. Mother, I don't know about you, but as a parent, leave my children alone. I'd much rather you mess with me than to mess with my kids. I want to know, is there any parents in the building right now? Come on, somebody. That would do anything to save your child. There's no distance that you won't travel. There's no expense that you will not take. If it became between yourself and your child. I know some parents right here, right now, that's going without. Just because they want to make sure their children got shoes and their feet, clothes and their house, and a roof over their head.
Amen.
Amen. So I know we can relate, amen, to this woman who was desperate. I can only imagine what she had to go through, amen, prior to running into Jesus. Amen. Don't have you ever been in a place,
yes,
amen, where you taking them to doctors, taking them to therapists, showed up at PTA meetings, and you know you're tired, but you have to take them to sporting events. Amen. You know you much rather just lay on down. Amen. Amen. But you sacrifice your own body. Amen. To make sure that, you know, they have every opportunity, you know, that you can give them,
yes,
to have a,
yes,
vibrant and successful life. But now something has threatened that. Amen. Don't think because we're talking about demon possession, amen, that we're just talking about biblical times. Or I ran into a whole bunch of folk that has been possessed by demons. You ain't talking to me no more. Amen. And I ministered to a lot of young people, children. Amen. Amen. That act like they lost their wacky minds. Amen. Amen. Y'all act like you don't know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You know, the Bible says, honor thy mother and thy father.
Amen.
That's what I came up on, but I don't know, amen. I don't know what these kids are coming up
amen.
On. Because I'm not drinking the Kool-Aid.
Amen.
Amen. And so we have to understand how desperate this situation has devolved into. Amen. Amen. And on top of that, amen. She was a part of the ones that they call saved. Ain't nobody want to hear that. Amen. Amen. Because the Bible emphasized that she was a Canaanite woman. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. You understand that society is built around, amen, the clean and the unclean.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the have and the have nots. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, praise the Lord. You don't know what I'm talking about. Amen. You know, the society today was, you know, that day, you know, they were split. The Jews was the chosen people. Amen. God's plan was to bring salvation into the whole world. Amen. But the plan was, amen, that salvation will go through the Jews.
Amen.
But what happens, amen, when God's plan, amen, ain't working out to your benefit at that particular time? You ain't working with me. Amen. God always has a plan.
Yeah.
Amen. Do you know you pray the Lord's Prayer, let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven? Amen. But what happens, amen, when his will ain't lining up with your circumstance? Amen. What happens, amen, when God's will is to bring salvation to you, but you're not at the top of the list at this particular time? Amen. Amen. It leaves you in a place where you feel like you're on the outside looking in. Has everybody ever felt like, amen, folk was just so churchy? Amen. Have you ever met somebody Holy Ghost fire baptized?
Amen.
And you know, amen, that you need a word from the Lord. Amen. But if you decide to go to them, amen, they may not even talk to you.
Amen.
You know, you just came out from wherever you just came from, and I'm not going to get into that, amen, because we all came from somewhere.
Amen.
In our lives, we all came from somewhere in our lives, amen. We all wasn't born with a Bible in our hands.
Amen.
And come on, praise the Lord, amen. Amen. I didn't come out, amen, and I automatically start preaching for my mama. No, it's just like everybody else. It's been a journey. Come on, can somebody witness it's been a journey, amen. Amen. I've been in some places you would never know, because I ain't going to tell you, amen. And I don't want to know where you've been, amen, man. Because I may have met you alone. No. Let's leave the past in the past.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody, amen. Amen. And yet, in the midst of it all, amen, we're not who we were. Amen. Amen. I'm not the same man that I was. Amen. I come into a new understanding. And I got new responsibilities on my life. Amen. I can't go out clubbing with you on tonight. Amen. I gotta stay home. I got my family that I don't know. Amen. And here it is now that we find this woman. Amen. And she knows she's in trouble. And she knows that from what she heard, that this Jesus from Bethlehem is able to deliver her child.
Amen.
And so she searches Jesus out. Amen. Praise the Lord. How many of you know, amen, sometimes you got to search?
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. We always wait on God to come to us. Amen. But sometimes you got to go find where God's at.
Amen.
Hallelujah,
somebody. Oh, I know God can bless you in your house. I know God can bless you in your car. But sometimes you got to pick up your own feet. Sometimes you got to make an effort, amen, and go to where Jesus is, amen. Amen. I know you're waiting on God, but at the same time, God is waiting on you. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. Sometimes you can't wait till Sunday, amen, to get to church. Amen. You got to go ahead and go to God while you're still in your house, while you're still in your room, while you're still in your bed. You got to go find them. Hallelujah, somebody. I can't wait, amen, for somebody to give me directions. I gotta go find him. My child is in jeopardy. Her life is on the line. And you ain't gonna slow me down. Amen. Praise the Lord. I know some of us is big time now. Amen. You come a long way. Praise the Lord. Amen. You're fine now. Nice clothes, nice cars, roof over your head, everything nice. Amen. You know you don't come out and look in any old way. Come on, somebody, praise the Lord. Everything God be good. Amen. Praise the Lord. But this Canaanite woman, the Bible reports, amen, the Canaanite woman, praise the Lord, she didn't care about none of that. Amen. Amen. The Bible says she cried behind the Lord. Yes. Amen. That means she cried out to the Lord. She began to make herself look like a fool. Come on, somebody. Praise the Lord. Amen. Jesus. Amen. Amen. In the crowd, Jesus. Amen. Crowd looking at her. Be quiet. Amen. Jesus, have mercy on me. Sometimes folks will tell you to go away, but you got to keep on going anyway. Amen. They don't know what you're going through. They don't know what you need in your life. That's why, amen, they tell you to be quiet, but you got to keep on crying out loud. Have mercy on me, God. Hallelujah. I know that's true because the disciples talk about, amen, Lord, send her away. Amen. She following us. She wasn't following the disciples. She was following Jesus. Isn't it funny how folk want to take credit for Jesus? I'm not following you. I'm not coming to church for you. I'm not here for you. Whether you talk to me or shoo me away, whether you walk by me, don't say a word. I ain't come here looking for you. Come on. Amen. Praise the Lord. I came here looking for Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Amen. Your desperation, amen, allows a level of persistence. Praise God. Amen. Watch this. Amen. You may quit on other things, but you can't quit now. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. This ain't no game now. Come on, somebody. This is life and death situation going on here. Amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I can't quit now. Don't tell me to be quiet. Amen. Don't tell me to go away. Amen. I'm on mission right now.
This is a theological question that I'm about to pose to you. And I hope you can help me answer it. What do you do when you cry out to the Lord and he remains silent? Did somebody hear me? What do you do when you ask God? You're crying out to him. You're desperate. And he remains silent. What do you do? Do you begin to question yourself? Will the devil start planting seeds in your head? Trying to say that you've done something? Amen. And because you've done something, amen, you are not deserving, amen, to be heard by God. Come on. I know I'm talking to somebody in this building. Amen. Praise the Lord, amen. I know I'm not by myself. Amen. I'm wondering, amen, what did I do? Amen. To have God ignore me right now. Have I done something? Amen. Lately, amen, that causing God, amen, to be silent to my cry.
Amen.
And the answer I heard y'all say, wait on the Lord. Amen. Yeah, I heard that. Amen. And that is absolutely correct. Wait on the Lord and build what? Good courage. You know what good courage is. Amen. Amen. That courage that don't come from man, that courage that comes from the Spirit of God, that courage, amen, that comes from trusting in the Word of God. Amen. You just can't have good courage any time. Amen. Good courage is built up. Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
But there's a greater answer here. Amen. And the greater answer is sometimes, amen, God will be silent because he needs your faith to be elevated.
Oh.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Oh, it's easy to trust God when you hear from him. Amen. But when you ain't hearing nothing, amen, and you don't got no other evidence, amen, that God is going to work it out, and you know your heart is palpitating in your chest, you know your stomach is tied up in knot, you know you can't keep no food down, and yet you still got to have faith in God, saying that God is going to work it out on your behalf. In other words, God uses silence, amen, to build up your faith,
right,
to elevate your faith. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Because the faith that you need, amen, when you're going through the grocery store, amen, and you're like, I only got to put this on my budget, so you got to put this back and that back. That's a different type of faith, amen, than having faith, amen, to understand, hey, God, my child is about to die. My child is on the line. God, I need your help right now. That's a different type of faith.
Amen.
It's a different type of faith. Amen. It ain't just one type of faith. Amen. Praise the Lord. You need some faith. Amen. Just dealing with day-to-day stuff. But what type of faith you need? Amen. When your back is up against the wall. Amen. You in the corner. You know there ain't no way out. Amen. God uses silence. Amen. To elevate your faith. Most Christians walk away. Amen. Because they don't hear from God. And they miss the opportunity.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. To have their faith elevated.
Amen.
To a place. Amen. Where God says all things.
Amen.
Did somebody hear me?
Amen.
Elevate to a place where all of us are. I can't even get it out. Amen. Elevate to a place. Amen. Where all things are possible.
Amen. Amen.
The last part to that is to them that believe.
Yes.
Are you a believer on?
Yes.
Are you a believer? Are you a believer? Amen. In form only? Or are you a believer? Amen. In season and out of season. I believe in God. Amen. I believe in the Father. I believe in his power. I believe in his justice. I believe in his love. I believe in his bountiness. I believe in his goodness. I believe in his mercy. I believe in his grace. Is anybody out here? That is a believer. Hallelujah. Believer.
Yes.
Amen.
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 She moves past the silent part. She wouldn't be deterred. She was determined. Amen. Then Jesus' response to her was phenomenal. I don't know how she was able to do it. Except I read it over and over again. I began to understand. The bread that I have is not for you. is for the people, the Jewish people. I'm paraphrasing, forgive me. Amen. If I don't get it word from word, don't hold it against me. I'm only human.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, and then he turns around and says, what I have, the bread that I have, is not for you. Amen. Amen. It's not for the dogs. It's not for the dogs. It's for his chosen people. Many of us would have just walked away.
Yes, Lord.
What did you call me? This is Jesus. Yeah, I know some of you are smiling. You're acting too churchified for me right now. Amen. But I know some of your ladies got some Vaseline in your bags right now. Let a brother turn around and call you out of your name. Church or no church. Sunday or no Sunday. The Lord communion, no Lord communion. What you call me? And the inference, as she being a Canaanite woman, is given the inference that she was a black woman. Come on, somebody, amen. They put another layer of something on that. Amen. Don't mess with the sister. I wish somebody work with me, amen. Amen. That sister thing is serious. Praise the Lord, amen. That sister stuff is serious, amen. But her response was also phenomenal. Because sometimes God will answer you to test you.
Amen.
My. How bad do you want it? Will you forgo your attitude? Will you forgo your egoism? Are you willing to let go the truth? Amen. The name calling. Amen. The societal separation. Were you willing to let all that go? Amen. Because you still know that he's Savior. And that the only way that your daughter's going to get saved is through him.
Amen.
Or are you willing to suffer that? And her response was, listen, even the dogs eat the crumbs from their master's table. Come on, somebody. And Jesus, amen, and Jesus was so taken back, amen, by her response. Amen. That he says, how great, no greater faith have I seen. Amen. Elevation.
Yes.
Did you hear it?
Yes.
Hold on. Let me get this part right. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because I'm bringing it home. Praise the Lord. And it says, amen. It is not meet to take the bread and cast it to dogs. And she said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. And Jesus answered and said, O woman, great is thy faith.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And don't you know, amen, that God wants your faith to be great?
Yeah.
He don't want average faith in your life anymore. Amen. We are about to move into a time. We are about to move into a season. Amen. That the average faith ain't going to work. Amen. But we need some great faith. We need some folk up in here, praise the Lord, that's able to get some prayers through. We need some folks up in here, amen, that's able to get down on their knees and won't come off of their knees until the Lord answers their prayers. We need some great folk. We need some great faith folk, amen, that won't quit no matter how bad it will get. I'm going to press towards the high call and the high bar of Jesus Christ. Can I get a witness? Crowns can elevate you. Amen. Amen. Don't worry about the crown part. Amen. Because a crown will bless you when the applause from the Lord's table. I was playing around with another title, amen, with this sermon, praise the Lord, amen. I was playing with the title, Crummy Blessings, amen, Crummy Blessings, amen. But you got to understand, if you have faith, the size of a mustard seed, come on somebody, amen, you don't need a whole lot. Amen. You don't need a whole lot. But if you get a crumb from the Lord, amen, a crumb can cover your whole life. A crumb, amen, can cover your whole house. A crumb can deliver your whole family.
Thank you, Lord.
So you don't invite me to the table? Let me just get down on my knees. And let me search for the crumb that falls from God's table.
Yes.
And if I can get me a crumb, I know that everything is going to come. I know that everything is going to be all right. Elevated by crumbs. Amen. Elevated by crumbs. In the name of the Father, name of the Son, and name of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Put your hands together. Hallelujah. You may stand to your feet. We need to be a church that is driven by purpose. Amen. I think the model for churches, particularly lately, has been to exchange memberships. Amen. You may go to this church, change membership, come over. That's all well and good. But ultimately, our assignment is to make new disciples.
Amen.
To bring new people into the body of Christ. I don't know exactly what happened to this young girl. Amen. All I know is that she was caught up in something she couldn't get herself out of. And you may know people like that is caught up and don't know which way to get out. If you're under the sound of my voice, amen, and you want to help them, offer them Jesus.
Amen.
We need to get back to the basic.
Amen.
The pinpoint, the center point of it all.
Amen.
Is to bring people into the body of Christ.
Amen.
That's why no matter what your age, you can't get tired. Because you always have an opportunity to witness.
Amen.
I believe everybody under the sound of my voice has given their life to Jesus, but if you have not given your life to Jesus, we invite you to the altar and come. Don't worry about, remember what I said before, what the Lord said before, don't worry about how they may speak or say or whatever. Nobody knows your story except for you and God.
Amen.
And if you haven't, if you don't know him for the pardoning of your sins, meaning the forgiveness of your sins, my mind needs to be forgiven. My body needs to be forgiven. I need salvation from God. Grateful. If you find yourself outside of that, we invite you to come and be a part of our spiritual body of Christ. And if you don't have a church home, certainly, we invite you to this place and make this church your church home. Is there one? Is there one? You may take your seats. Amen. 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 This is the day that the Lord continues to bless us in. Amen. And as he is blessing us, we are lifting and giving offering. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're not afraid to give. Can't be afraid to give. God gave to us. We give to God in our offerings. It's monetary, yes. But it is necessary, yes. We're asking that you would give what is called your tithe, which is 10% of your increase, whether that be through check, monthly, whatever the case may be. Yes, I'm talking about your Social Security check. Silence. No matter what it is, you know, God says, I will bless the 90 when you give to me freely. And your heart needs to be in the right place.
Amen.
Amen. When you give freely, amen, of your heart, tithe offering, 10%. You keep 90, give God 10. Then we have what we call our faith seed offering, our 75-75 offering, to help us to pay off our debt. But I use the 75-75, amen, when I stand in need of a particular blessing. I want to sow into that. I need help in this area, God. I'm sowing into that. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. So I'm sowing the 75-75 seed. I know it's going to bless the church. Help the church get out of debt. At the same time, I'm praying God to help me in this particular circumstance. Sowing the seed. And then lastly, we in general claim season. Amen. Our general claims are $350. Amen. We're asking everybody to work towards that $350. Amen. To help the overhead of the church.
Amen.
Y'all came in, you already got your jackets and your coats on and everything else. I pray that it's nice and toasty in here, but toasty don't come for free.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Somebody. Amen. Toasty don't come for free. Amen. I tried to talk to the old man and the old, tell the old man, well, we good people over here. He said, oh, that's wonderful. Listen, Pastor, you want 200 gallons inside the tank at the church, it's going to cost you this much. Amen. I just say that, amen, to put a smile on your face.
Amen.
But sometimes we need to understand. You know, we don't go through this for nothing. Amen. It's a responsibility that we all share in maintaining God's house.
Amen.
And we ask that you will help us through that general claims offering. Amen. Pay it in parts. If you pay it at one time, pay it at one time. But pay it in parts. Amen. Until you pay it and it's paid in full. Faith. By faith. By faith. Amen. Praise the Lord.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad. And be glad in you. Oh, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in you. Thank you.
Sister Gladys, why don't you just pass that mic, amen, you know, behind the Sister Hensley. Because, you know, you're about to get busy. Deaconess, please prepare the house, amen, for the Lord's Supper. Amen. Sister Hensley, just bless us with a few selections. Amen. Thank God there's nothing wrong with your hearing. God is merciful. Amen, amen, amen. Just for you that's not accustomed to us, we one family. Amen, praise the Lord. The Bible says, I'm very serious about this, honor thy mother and thy father, so that your days upon the earth, amen, shall be long. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So Sister Hensley says something to me, I just like, okay, Mike. But I do need you to sing. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory.
Somebody pray for me. Had me on their mind. Took the time to pray for me.
I'm so glad.
I'm so glad they prayed. I'm so glad they prayed. I'm so glad they prayed for me. The preacher preached for me. Had me on his mind. Took the time to pray for me. I'm so glad he prayed. I'm so glad he prayed. I'm so glad he prayed for me.
Amen, amen, amen. Will we please stand? Amen, please stand. Please turn to the back of your handbook, page number 12. In the back of your handbook, it says the Lord's Supper, the Great Invitation. It's in the back of your handbook. Amen. It's where all the rituals are at. If you need, you know, if you need somebody to come over, help your neighbor, praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. We want to be neighborly. Amen. Amen. Page 12 at the top, it says the Lord's Supper, the Great Invitation. Amen. I want everybody to be on the same page. To God be the glory. Amen. Amen. Just waiting for the house. Amen. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. Wherefore, ye that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and on love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in this holy way, drawn near with faith, taking your holy sacrament to your comfort, and devoutly kneeling, making your humble confessions to Almighty God. You may take your seats. There you will find underneath that the general confession. We say this together. Let's say it together. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, by word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, and forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for thy great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them with hearty repentance and true faith, turning to thee, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Top of page 13, it says to collect for the purity. Let us say this together. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We do not presume to come to this thy holy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is to always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may live and grow thereby, and that being washed through his most precious blood, we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
This is the place for which the consecration, which means the setting aside for the elements, is taking place. I say this, ordained elder in the church can only do this. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for thy tender mercy did thee give thy only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his oblation of himself once offered the full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and then instituted in his holy gospel, command us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O most of Father, we humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, and remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. During the same night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, for this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which was shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye like in remembrance of me. My Father's children, amen. I take now the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I take it, I break it, I eat it, and I am so grateful for the healing properties, the crumb that has fallen from the Master's table has come into my possession. And I am healed. Man cannot explain what happened at the hill of Calvary. A spear was stuck on the side of our Savior. The Bible reports blood and water came out. It was that sacrifice that God himself made that allowed resurrection to take place 3 days later. I drink His blood. And I am so grateful to be in remission of sins. Forgive me, and I shall be forgiven. Forgive others as God has forgiven you. On page 14, the first line says, it is very meet. Let's say this together. It is very meet and right and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God. Therefore, with the angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord, most high.
Amen.
Deaconess, I'm going to need more elements, please.
We have.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Usher, will you please assist me in leading people down the middle of the house so that they may receive their communion? Starting from the rear of the church, you will receive your communion elements and then go back to your seats and wait for the instructions to follow.
What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me bright as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Can't let me whole again. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
God bless you. Amen.
God bless you. Amen. Oh,
amen. Take this one, son. God bless you. God bless you.
Nothing but the blood. For my pardon, this I see, nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my cleansing, this my plea, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me bright as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Amen. We're going to share with this communion together. Please peel back the top to reveal the wafer, the crumb that has fallen from the master's table. Take it into your fingers, break it in half, and eat it. I give you a little time. Amen. And everybody has eaten. Peel off the top, take the bread, eat it. Thank you. as those that are still going through the wafer, we're going to continue on. Please remove the foil from the cup. Peel it back, please. Now drink his blood. You are in the mission sense. If anybody needs a substitute, please let us know. Raise your hand. If anybody needs a substitute in the back? Okay, we need two more, Sister Bradley. We need two more in the back, please. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. There's enough time to make sure everybody receives elements. Sister Bradley, please raise your hand all the way to the back. Amen. Trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. My father's children, I did not receive the announcements on the day, Sister Kim. Is there any announcements that you would like to share with the church family?
Good morning, Durham family. No, I don't have any announcements.
Amen. To God be the glory. We have an absentee on the day. Amen. Sister Sandra Green. Amen. Preacher steward of the church. Praise the Lord. She's not on vacation. She slipped and fell on yesterday. Amen. And I seen the pictures, is swelling around the eye and the face.
Yeah.
Amen. But to God be the glory, she all right.
Yeah.
I prayed with her this morning. Amen. And God came in. And I said something similar. I share with you. Amen. The enemy must realize your elevation.
Amen.
So all he's trying to do is trip you up.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But God got you.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Sometimes we have to fall on our faces.
Yes.
But we got to get back up again.
Amen.
So we're praying for Sister Green. Give her a call. Amen. Let her know that you're praying for her. Amen. Because she will turn around and do the same for you always.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So let her know, amen, that you are praying for her quick recovery.
Amen.
Amen. On this week, we are going up to Farming. No, we're going into Connecticut. And this is the Leadership Institute that the Bishop was speaking about. When we arrive back, we will give you a full report and accounting, amen, of what God has done. So on Thursday and Friday, we will be out of town. Amen. But you will always be able to reach me via my phone number, my cell phone number. How many of you have my cell phone number? Or I should ask the question, how many of you don't have my cell phone
number?
That's a fair question. Would you like my phone number? Would you like my phone number? I feel like I'm over here trying to date somebody. Nobody want my number. Nobody want to call me. You want to call me? I want somebody to call me. Everybody always say that pastor's too busy. No, I just want somebody to call me. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. I'm reachable. Amen. My number is 631-935-6644. 631-935-6644. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's my mobile number. I don't have a special number. I don't have a number just for church phone. That's my one and only phone number that I have. And I want you to have it. Because if you need prayer, you need something from the man of God, call me. Don't contemplate how busy I am. I'm never busy to do what I've been called to do.
Amen.
I've been called, you know, to take care of the sheep, the flock. And your life matters to me.
Amen.
Your well-being matters to me. And the only thing that perhaps we can do is pray over the phone.
Amen.
But don't discount crumbs.
Amen.
I'm working with y'all. Amen.
Amen.
The devil wants you to say that I don't bother. But it's the crumb blessings that makes the biggest impact in your life.
Amen.
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 All right. Sage, thank you so much for putting those breadsticks. Appreciate you, amen. Amen. I'm praying for the Yankee fans all over. Praying for y'all. The Lord have mercy on us Jet fans on this past Thursday. Amen. I feel your pain, brother. Me and you together on that. Amen.
What, they lost?
No, they won.
Oh.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Reverend Evers, I did just want to, last week I forgot to announce that Brother Bill celebrated his birthday, so.
Amen, Brother Bill. Brother Bill, amen, amen. Congratulations, Brother Bill, amen. Amen, young man, I pray God blessings continue to be upon you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And Brother Bill, don't worry, I'm not buying you flowers. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, I need to go. I need to let y'all go. Amen. I need to let y'all go. Praise the Lord.
Of silver.
Of water.
Lord, it has come time now that we bring this wonderful worship experience to a conclusion. But although, oh God, this worship experience is coming to an end, our worship is continuous. We know the God for which we serve. Continue, O Father God, to help us to elevate our faith to even just a crumb that falls from your table. We thank you, O God, for this, and ask that although we are being dismissed from this place, never ever dismiss us from your sight. Never ever have us to be without your presence. Now unto him that's able to keep you from falling, to present you faultless before his throne in grace for this evening joy. To the only wise God our Creator be glory and majesty, power, dominion, both now, henceforth, and forevermore. That all of God's children say in threefold, Amen. 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 My Father's children, continue to be blessed because you are blessed.
Okay, I just want to make a quick announcement since I was on the voter registration.
Recording stopped.
And church, please, if you have not voted, today's the last day.